passionate about the First Amendment. So my time tonight will be focused on introducing an artist that will help you fight censorship. But before we can explore his music, art, and film, I want to introduce you to Brian Warner. Brian was born in 1969 in Canton, Ohio. He was born to Hugh Warner and his wife, Barbara. Hugh was a Vietnam War vet and was exposed to Agent Orange. So Brian's childhood was tortured with tests, didn't really get to have much of a childhood, just always in fear of his own genetics. He went to a Christian school from first grade to 10th grade, where he sold candy because it wasn't allowed in school. When his teachers tried to teach him what music not to listen to, he only fell in love with it more, making him want to buy albums from artists like Ozzy and Kiss even more. Eventually, he moved out of Canton, Ohio, to South Florida, where he wrote for a music magazine, and eventually using his interviewees as case studies. Brian wanted to hold a black mirror to society and reflect its animalistic nature. He noticed we give as much notoriety to gorgeous, accomplished women as we give to sick, twisted deviants like Charles Manson. And so Marilyn Manson was personified. As soon as Marilyn Manson was personified, he started advertising. He actually drew this himself. So he was very into propaganda and thought if people saw his name everywhere, they would think he was famous. And So by the time they booked their first show, they hadn't written a single song yet. So they winged their first show, but had to work out some major kinks before releasing their first album in 1993. The first album, Portrait of an American Family and Smells Like Children, were very calm compared to his third album, Antichrist Superstar. This is when Manson wanted to challenge the band. They started playing with sleep deprivation and near constant drug use. He wanted to get a really authentically hostile sounding record, and he did. Next, he wanted to challenge himself again, this time taking inspiration from the glam rock of the 1970s with Mechanical Animal. He then had 7 albums after that to present day. Each one has a different feel and a different inspiration. So when rock fans tell me they don't like Marilyn Manson, I tell them they haven't found their album yet. And if rock just isn't for you, there are other ways you can enjoy Marilyn Manson. Manson is a multimedia artist. He's formed 2 triptychs with his record. So if you don't know what a triptych is, it's originally, it described a painting meant to go together to like tell a story. So the panels would come up, it would sometimes be used as an altar. So those are the records that form a triptych. So then with this, it should be no surprise to you that Marilyn Manson does have a background in painting. So he has even had his own art shows. Tyler, you might be interested. I wanted to point out to Kyle as well, but you should be interested that most of these were painted with a watercolor palette and absinthe in place of water. As an alcohol connoisseur, I figured you might find that interesting.
Yeah, that's
so then.
That's awesome.
I think you got that from Trent, too.
So then with that, Manson actually came out with his own brand of absinthe. You can go ahead and show that. So this is his absinthe. It's kind of tilty right there. So then finally, we've seen his art and kind of he made that picture, too. So so most of us have seen Manson in movies and TVs without even noticing it. He played alongside the child actor Dylan and Cole Sprouse in The Heart is Deceitful Above All Things. He appeared in Jawbreakers, Party Monsters, and The Lost Highway. He's also appeared in the TV shows Californication as a version of himself, Eastbound and Down, Once Upon a Time, Sons of Anarchy. A lot of people don't know that that was Manson because he did gain a lot of weight for that role. And then Salem. He even did the intro music for Salem. So Manson is a complex person, and his art is meant to elicit a response. So Marilyn Manson is why I feel comfortable dressing more extreme like I did today. But why I'm comfortable dressing the way I do every day. Manson has cleared the way for us to express ourselves. Lady Gaga's gotten a lot of crap for her theatrical wardrobe, but she can do it without protest because Manson did go through the protests in the 90s and cleared the way for us to express ourselves. So he broke down the stigmas and just watch, if you don't like the music, watch the music, or I'm sorry, if you don't like his music, look up some paintings, watch some movies. Marilyn Manson's always trying to tell us something deeper, and I do encourage you to look into art that will make you think about things in a more deeper way.